Ladies and gentlemen, it's match number 10. It's a women's W pool game. It's our defending Asian World 7 Series champions, Japan. And they are taking on Singapore. Please welcome Japan and Singapore.
Well, welcome back to the Asian 7 Series. Streaming live from the Hong Kong Football Club. Great morning of rugby so far as we approach lunchtime. And this is the Japanese squad on camera. Always feature as one of the top two or three teams in Asia. And they're taking on the Singaporean team. Let's see what colour strip they're in for this game. They are in their black and Japan in the red.
Your referee for this match, Mr. Matt Rodden from Hong Kong.
So Japan will kick off playing left to right. And Singapore. They've got some good skills, Singapore. They probably punch above their playing weight, as it were, in Asian rugby. Japan just fringing around the outside there. So Singapore get a penalty inside their 22. Be interesting to see whether they run this one or if they go for the line out. Indeed, they'll tap it and run away. Don't know about that. I mean, you see here they've been hemmed in by a fast approaching defensive line. So Japan get a turnover, and this is good quick ball for Japan too. They get it. Oh, that's a poor pass though from Japan. Takeuchi giving the ball away, gifting it to Singapore. Good determined run there from Singapore, but no real pace from Christabel Mee. But another penalty, and this will be good. And the Singapore player scampers. Samantha Teo gains 20 metres for her team. Slow ball here though from the recycling. Oh, smashed in the tackle. Poor old Go Xinye got absolutely blasted. Oh, nice run. Beautiful low centre of gravity from Yoko Suzuki. And the Singapore players will be saying, Yoko, oh no, we let it go away. For the try,
the first try of the game. Scored by Japan number 9, Yoko Suzuki.
Nothing worse than having your mic fail
and
when you're cracking the joke.
Successful conversion, Japan 7,
we've had
Singapore 0.
Guffawing, but never mind, you'll have to watch the replay on that one. 7-0, the conversion successful try from Yoko Suzuki. Kickoff from Kanematsu. Again, the girl's going for that spot around the 22-metre line. And a knock-on, it pays dividends here for Japan, who will get a scrum inside the 22. And there's a try scorer with the ball in her hands, Yoko Suzuki, just a diminutive player, but sometimes it really pays to have one of those low centers of gravity when you've got so much space to play with in the sevens game. Look at her again. Didn't really draw the defense there, but Nakamura has done really well, hitting the ball at pace and gets within 1 meter away. And pretty elementary here for Japan to dot the ball down. Oh, she made it harder than it needed to be there, Kuwai. And good defense from the Singapore player to try and deny it. But Kuwai goes over for the second try of the match. 12-0.
Second try for Japan, scored by number 4, Ano Kuwai.
Tino Hirawini back in the commentary box.
Conversion falls short this time.
The starters box
12,
ready for
Singapore
the next
nil.
Game. Looks psyched up to deliver some of the best commentary you'll hear this side of Dubai. It's Kanematsu who gets things underway again, and again, they just find it hard to control that ball. And Japan have sadly been denied a try. There's a little knock on there from Takeuchi. So Singapore will get the put in here. It's Go Shinyi, number five there. We'll put the ball into the scrum. Let's see what sort of pressure Japan can apply. And they do too. Yoko Suzuki's grabbed the ball away from Go. Nice little netball pass to Kanematsu, who jinks and jives. Gets us back to where the scrum was. With Japan in possession now. Here's Nakamura, who looks strong. Great to physicality. Spills the ball though. Here's Suzuki. Squeezes the ball out. And good timing there from Singapore. Here's Annabelle Wu, who smashed over the ball. Good strong play from Annabelle. Christabel Ni kicks it nicely to touch into the breeze. So that's a bit of technique, I think, from the Singapore team. A couple of times have been awarded penalties inside their 22. With no surprise, it's pretty tough to get out of your 22 with ball on hand. There's no noted line breakers for Singapore. Sometimes better just to slow it down and take the set piece. Be confident enough that you're going to regain the ball here at the line out. Oh, maybe we spoke too soon because Japan have taken this off them. Takeuchi getting up high on the line out. Here's a rangy runner. It's Chrisato Yoku. Slow ball for Japan. Here's Suzuki. Oh, she's an elusive runner, isn't she? Suzuki Taneuchi. Well done. Good hands there from Yamada. Thanks, Les, for the commentary inspiration. Yuki Su. There's still 30 or 40 meters out. Oh, here's this girl. What a rangy runner she is. It's Yuku who goes away. With her first touch of the ball, she appeals.
Try beneath the post.
They have some
Japan,
spring and a step.
Seven.
And second touch, she goes Yaku. Over for the try. Chrisato Yuku. Well, Nakamura has a try at converting, but no luck for her. Seems like Kanematsu, their first choice kicker, is off the field, so Nakamura will go back to halfway and restart as well. Unusual for a forward to take these responsibilities up. But probably quite a reasonable idea if they've got the kicking goods. Let the fast, sprightly girls chase the ball down. You punt it away from Simon at halfway and sit back and watch the quick girls run up and put pressure on Singapore. So Singapore, just before half time, again, this very, very fast defensive lineup for Japan. Good work from Low, the Singapore winger, but can't deny the Japan try.
And on the stroke of half time, a try for Japanese number two, Aya Takeuchi.
And that will be half-time after this conversion attempt from Nakamura. Judging by the first one, we might as well put the ball down and go to a huddle. Let's see if she's... Oh, it's a bitter attempt, got to be said. Oh, off the upright. Fair enough from Nakamura.
Skipper Nakamura.
Sorry to downplay her kicking ability. She's
off the wire.
Done pretty well there with that attempt.
Half-time with Japan leading 22-0.
So half-time, the score is 22-0, Japan over Singapore. the Philippines player with no number, Zapia. Yep. Pretty tough game for Singapore so far, leaking four tries. Not sure what coach Denny Tauroa would have said at halftime. But maybe it's actually, it could be an interesting tactic to play for a bit of territory for Singapore. They've been really penned inside their 22 as Japan take this one away. Let's see if they can turn the tables on Japan and just hold them down in here. Well, they've got a penalty. So a chance here for Singapore early on in the second half to get some points on the board. It's Lo Yu Hui who takes the tap. Oh, knock on though. Well, in fact, it's a knock on for. But now it's a Koide. There was also a bit of a flyer down the outside as well. And Koide runs 50 meters for her first try. Came on at halftime. Good introduction for her.
Try for Japanese number 11, Mifuyu Koide. And Mifui converts her own try to take the score to 29 points to nil. And that's technically called a goal.
Okay, well, Japan restart, and you can bet it's going to go to the 22. It's been there every time at the restarts, four or five times, and still no Singapore player filling that gap. In fact, now we have Lo Yu Hui go back. This one's, yeah, again, just outside the 22 this time, and again, the ball finds ground. You would have thought after four or five times, you might think there'd be some players there to fetch. Then again, I guess give the Japanese kicker the benefit of the doubt. She's kicking into the space provided. Singapore take the ball to the 22 now in defense again. Gainfully keeping the ball in hand and trying to crack this Japanese defensive line. Very well organized, has to be said though. Always on their feet, quickly to their feet again. The work rate, great turnover. So it goes to Koide, it's just scored a try. Probing the right side of the field here, and good strength from Takeuchi. She's got to Koide, pleading for the ball outside to Yuku. Koide again. Yuku and Koide, two young Japanese players, showing a lot of spirit and skill here. Here's Yuku, who finds herself in the tight exchanges. Good blow over the top there from the Japanese player, Suzuki. But wasn't enough to get the ball back, so penalized. And again, here's the kick from Christabel Limmi, who gets them to 40 meters outside their line. It's great to see the young ladies taking up contact rugby. A lot of them start with touch rugby. I know, looking at some of these Singaporean girls, they started at high school playing touch rugby, gained the confidence and skill, ball handling, and then decided to step up to the more physical level. That line out throw goes a little awry there from Singapore. And it's all about technique. There's some great techniques in the women's game as far as tackling and defense goes. Oh, beautiful acceleration off the mark from Yamada. Oh my goodness, what explosive pace. Within a split second, she was away from the defense and strode unopposed 45 meters to the try line.
Rei Yamada. And another boot conversion. Mifuyi Koide. Japan 36, Singapore yet to score.
This has been a bit of a walk in the park for Japan against Singapore, 36-0 so far. It's got to be fair to say that Singapore haven't stopped trying. And here's a short kickoff. Will it go the 10 metres? No. Will the Singaporean player touch it? No. Free kick at halfway. Ali Sudera thought about picking the ball up. Let's see if Singapore has some tricks up their sleeve. Samantha Teo takes it from halfway. Support arrives just in time to recycle that ball. Here's Ali Sudera. Nice little step off the right foot. Just clustered around the ball at the moment, Singapore. Trying to go up the middle. Might be the way through the Singapore defence. Now they fan out to the left. Nice little double round from Yilin Wong. So this is better from Singapore. Stringing a couple of phases together, though. Japan go in and reclaim the ball. So now time for a counter-attack. Here's Suzuki. And she gets it out wide. Now this is a good run here from Kuwai. Took her a while to get up to fourth gear, but what she did, gave the big handoff to the defender, Clarissa Lim, and away she went.
Another try for Ano Kuwai.
So that's the seventh try of this game for Japan. There's a minute left.
Stretching out Japan's
lead. And a pretty
lead.
Easy conversion attempt here from Kanematsu, who's come back on the field. Good rotation from the Japanese team. They've had girls on and off for 4 or 5 minute spells during the game, trying to keep their players fresh for those games later in the day.
Singapore yet to score.
Just 40 seconds left of this match, and Japan with a pretty impressive victory so far over Singapore, 43 points to nil. Just champing for the underdog. Love to see Singapore come away and break the shackles, as it were, in the last few seconds, but this Japanese defense has been unrelenting as Ali Sudera takes it. But again, turnover for Japan. Little knock on, though, in the contact area. So Singapore will have the last set piece of this game. In fact, will they have time? Yes, they will, by the looks of it, to form the scrum. Should be the last play of the game. Smart. This is about the third minute of extra time, as it were, and Japan have had enough. Koide shows she's got an old head on her young shoulders, smashes it into touch, and that will be the end of this game. A blow match between Japan and Singapore.
For the
and
second
a very
time
impressive
today,
victory
Japan
to Japan, 43 points to nil. Coming up next, Hong Kong women will be playing,
victors,
and we have a star in the making, Dai Reese, in the commentary booth.
And if you now cast your eyes towards the big screen, you'll see the first of our Lumi Kukri selfie photographs.